Hey guys, welcome to a new episode of Ander Verheven Music Production Tip. Today we're going to cover adding reverb in your project, and we're starting right now. I am Ander Verheven, I am an audio engineer, producer, and educator, and also I'm a mastering engineer at BusyWorks. Today I got a request from Michel Wima, and he was asking me, Ander, can you please tell me how you add reverb to a project? Well, Michel, no problem, we're going to cover this one. Massive Disorder, I have heard your request as well. We're going to cover this one next week because Michel Wima was a bit earlier than your request. But no problem, we see that next week. So I have the project over here. So by the way, if you like my channel, please subscribe, hit the notification bell and leave a comment down below with a thumbs up and it will be awesome. So reverb is mostly used for creating space in a specific element like vocals or guitar or synthesizer or whatever you want. And back in the days they didn't have the equipment that we have, so they had to make a room for that and place microphones in it, place curtains in it if they needed one or two, or just doing stuff in it to make special kind of reverbs. And later on, they had machines who replaced that. Also, the 19-inch, which came, I think, in the 80s or the 90s. I don't know. I had one also from Alesis. Again, Alesis, I also had the crumble compressor and also had a reverb. I don't have it anymore. So, going back to the project. This is the project. We're going to listen to it without the reverb. So this is without reverb. It sounds very dry. So Michel asked me, how can I do it on a decent way? It's very simple. I made a parallel channel over here, which is my reverb. I named it also reverb. Originally, it's an FX bus because you can add everything you want. And made a send over here. That means that it sends a copy of the signal over here. And I can place a reverb 100% on it. Now, to understand what is reverb doing, I have the room reverb of Presonus over here. Why I'm taking this plugin is because it makes also a good representation of the room, how it works, how the reflection works, how the height, like you can even adjust the height. Oh, so let's put it on. The width, the size of the room, and the height of the room. So you can easily make the room bigger or smaller. You also can do the distance of the microphones. You also can do the dampness, which probably is, if you have a lot of soft materials in it, like pillows, mattresses, or curtains, or everything at the same time. The pre-delay, when the reverb is hitting your ears, and the length of it. So at this moment I am pretty much standing in a church, and in this case I'm standing in a bathroom, I think. So that's how reverb works. It's adding space, not an extra effect on it. If you want to use it as an effect, that's going to be a total different approach. In this case, Michel asked me, how can I add it in a mix? Well, it's very simple. In a parallel processing, let's listen how it sounds. So as you can hear, it's pretty much spot on the sound itself. It doesn't leave any room for the sound itself. So how are we going to do a good control of the sound? Well, it's very simple. So we're adding a compressor, and this compressor is in sidechain mode. So it listens to the channel over here, and I told the compressor to listen to the synth sound. And Michel, I'm going to tell you something. There's a difference between post and pre-fading. Post means that it listened after the tail of the reverb, and pre-fading is listening before the whole process starts. And in this case, it listens to its tail. And that means that my reverb will never recover after the compressor ducks the whole sound because it's listened also to it still. So I'm setting it on pre-fader. So let's listen how that sounds. As you can hear, there's more control over it. If I take it away, it's immediately over the sound itself. And now it's pretty much ducking the reverb away and coming back when the sound, when the signal stops playing. Sorry. So this is how I control my reverbs, and I can add as much as I want. I can go pretty hardcore with this one. Bringing back the pre-delay. So this is how I usually do my reverb, like I already said. And there are different kinds of reverb, like you've seen me using this one, using a room reverb, or even a convolution reverb. And that means that I took a sample of the material itself, putting it in as a sample, and let's see how that sounds. Here it mimics the sounds, and you can play as much as you want with it. But this is a different approach, as you can see. It has, yeah, I don't know, it adds extra thing to it. It's nice to use this one as a, yeah, as an effect instead of using it on the mix. But I prefer always this type when I'm mixing. Bringing a little bit down of the, there we go. So it won't get in the way. And together with everything, it has a lot of reverb. I accidentally oversaturated this one. Now it's pretty spot on. This is how I like it. And this is basically how I do the reverb on it. And it works 9 out of 10 for every material. But you also have to understand what is reverb doing to my sound and why I am adding it and does it need it. Sometimes I placing a sound without reverb, it depends what you want to do with it. So I hope to see you guys next week, and next week we're going to cover your question, Massive Disorder. See you then. Hey, if you like the content of this video and you want to know more in depth about it, or you want to follow another masterclass in music production, you can contact me on info@andervrevenmusic.com or go to my Facebook page, which you can find on my channel in the right corner. See you then.